New Zealand is known as the seabird capital of the world. We have more species of seabird breeding here than anywhere else in the world by a very, very long margin. There are a whole bunch of different families of birds, but what they have in common is they all feed at sea.
Petrels in particular are really elusive bird. They come in at night to feed their chicks. Other than that, they're spending their life at sea. So it's really easy for people to miss them or not know that they are here. Once upon a time, seabirds would have been right across our mainland, and now they're mostly gone. And that's due to loss of habitat through deforestation, coastal developments, general disturbance as well with human recreation.
Globally, seabirds are the most threatened group of birds. The amount of introduced predators on our land now has really changed the environment, and seabirds in particular are really, really vulnerable to introduced predators. They nest underground in burrows. The adults will be feeding that chick continuously through until December, January, when that chick will fledge. And it takes both the parents feeding that little chick continuously for it to get up to its fledging weight. So it's a long process.
It's really important that we think about how we can be responsible pet owners. Even a dog on the beach can be really disturbing to a bird. The smell of them, just knowing they're there, the sense of a dog, a predator close by, can be really disturbing and stressful for birds on an ongoing basis. As well as following dog rules, you know, not letting your dog off the lead where they're not supposed to be.
Cats are special pets to many New Zealanders. They are parts of the family, and we want to encourage cat owners to start thinking about ways to reduce their cat's impact on wildlife, such as keeping them safe at home rather than letting them roam.
Fish is reducing by overfishing, so they face reduction in the nourishment for them to be able to feed. Other big threats involve pollutions and plastics in the ocean that sometimes is mistaken for food, and so basically they block their stomachs completely and they starve to death. Another threat that sometimes we don't think about here on land is light pollution. Because these birds are actually attracted to artificial lights, and birds get stranded and what we call a fall off. They just basically fall on the ground and they are not able to take off back again. They can be caught by predators, but just get run over by a car on the streets because a lot of the time lights are on roads.
We've got colonies coming back, particularly along the west coast of Auckland, from Murawai, all the way down to Cornwallis in the Manukau Harbour. So being able to volunteer in your local parks or doing backyard trapping and helping keep some of these predators under control is really important.
I'd really like people to know that these birds exist. They're birds we don't get to see every day. They're out of sight, out of mind, because they're out at sea. So just being aware that they exist and that they live these phenomenal lives and cover huge distances across the ocean to find food, and then bring that back into our environments, is just such a critical part of what makes them really, really special.